Good morning, children. You have already learned your English. Now it's time for a grammar session. And in today's class, you will be learning about noun. Chapter number 1 is noun. So, what is a noun? You have already learned in your previous classes that noun is a naming word. But it's very hard to just remember the things. So, a noun is a name of a person, place, animal, thing, idea or emotions. So in short, we can say that a noun is a naming word. Just as you play a game is in a name place. So in that way, the noun is the naming word. There are different kinds of noun. As I have written here in the board, common noun, proper noun, collective noun, abstract noun and possessive noun. Now, I will be telling you in detail each different type of noun with examples. Now, the first one is common noun. General names of people, places or things of same kind. That means it won't be giving you any specific name, such as school, toys, boys, books. Nothing name is given to the specified. And one more important thing of the common noun is they usually begins with a small letter. I will give you one example for this common noun is that he wrote many books. The books is a common noun. The second different type of noun is a proper noun. The name of a particular person, place or thing. That means that is giving you a specified name of a person, place or thing is known as a proper noun. And the second important the rule about the proper noun is they always begin with a capital letter. You should always remember when you are writing something in a proper noun, you have to begin with a capital letter. I have given one example down here. He wrote many books in English. So here, English is a proper noun. As now I have just explained to you about a common noun and proper noun, now I will be going with each exercise. First one is underline the nouns and you have to write whether it is a common noun or it's a proper noun. The first one is Munshi Premchand was a great writer. So Munshi Premchand is a proper noun and writer is a common noun. The second one is he wrote many books in Hindi. So here books is a common noun and Hindi is a proper noun. The third one of his famous book is Gordon. So here again, the books is a common noun and Gordon, the name of the book is a proper noun. The fourth one, his books are generally set in villages of northern India. So again here, books is a common noun and India specifying a country. So India is a proper noun. The fifth one, his books are translated into many languages. So again here, books is a common noun and one more common noun here is languages. The last one of this exercise is Gordon is available in Urdu, Hindi and English. So Gordon is a name of the book that Premchand has written. So Gordon is the proper noun and Urdu, Hindi and English is also a proper noun. Now exercise B is write the names of the groups of the following. The one is done for you in the board just as C. Yellow, orange, blue. It comes in the group of colors. The second question is peacock, woodpecker, eagle. It comes in the group of birds. The third one is football, hockey, badminton. It comes in the group of games. The fourth one is tea, cold drink, coffee. What is the group of it? It's a beverages. The fifth one, Ganga, Yamuna, Tripti. It comes in the group of rivers. The sixth one is table, chair, bed. It comes in the group of furniture. The seventh one, Tokyo, Mumbai, Los Angeles. It's come in the group of cities. Eighth one, mango, banana, watermelon. Group of fruits. Yes, you are right. The ninth one is Sunday, Wednesday and Thursday. It comes in the group of days of week. The last one of this exercise is pen, pencil, notebook. It comes in the group of stationery. The exercise C is match the each description. So your one has been written and also a help box is also given over there. So you have to just go there and just find out the correct answer and write it there. The first one is sell sweets and pastries. It's confectioner. The second one is flies an aeroplane. Who flies an aeroplane? It's a pilot. The third one is bakes bread. Who breaks bread? It's a baker. The fourth one, act in plays or movies. It's an actor. The fifth one, always expects good things to happen. Who always think that I should have always good thing is an optimist. The sixth one, does not eat meat. The person who does not eat meat is a vegetarian. So correct answer is vegetarian. The seventh one, always expects bad things to happen. Some people are like that, no? They always feel, if I do this, this will happen bad. This I will do this, so that might can be happen bad. The correct answer for the seventh one is pessimist. The eighth one, loves his country. The person who loves the country is a patriot. The ninth one, invites guests to the party. It's a, answer is host. And the tenth one, sells spectacles. Is an, what is the person who sells in a specs? Is an optician. Third such type is a collective nouns. The collective nouns are the name of a group of a people, animal or thing. That means in the collective noun it comes in a group, such as we can say the bouquet of flowers, the team of cricket players. One such example here again is a troupe of dancers came from London. So here the troupe of dancers is a collective noun. Whatever that comes in a group is known as a collective noun. Collective noun I have explained to you. Now goes the time for an exercise. Now in this exercise D, you have to choose the correct noun. One again I have done on the board for you. The first one, a bale of dash fell off the cart. The correct answer is cotton. The same way, the second one, we saw a pride of dash resting near the pond. The correct answer is lions. The third one, the gaggle of dash was swimming in the lake. Geese. The gaggle of geese was swimming in the lake. The fourth one, the child was lost in the crowd of dash outside the theater. The correct is crowd of people. It's a collective noun. The fifth one, a troupe of dancers was invited from Australia. The sixth one is, the captain could not find able crew of dash, crew of sailors. The sailors is the correct answer. The seventh one, Sharif brought a bouquet of dash for his wife. Bouquet of flowers. I told her when there is a group, the bouquet of flowers is a collective. The eighth one is, the carpenter carved a beautiful chest of dash. The carpenter carved a beautiful chest of drawers. The ninth one, the boy plucked a bunch of grapes from the vineyard. The tenth one is, the explorer had fleet of 10 ships. The fleet of 10 ships. The ship is the correct answer. The 11th one, Akhil recognized a few constellations of stars. The 12th one, a congregation of dash assembled to pray. The congregation of devotees. The 13th one, John ran up the flight of dash. John ran up the flight of steps. The 14th one, the suite of dash booked for us was huge. The suite of rooms. The rooms is the correct answer. The 15th one. Suman brought a string of dash for her mother. The correct answer for the 15th one is the string of pearls for her mother. Now, exercise E is also from the collective noun. In this exercise, you will be writing about rewrite using correct collective noun. What I have written on the board again, a pride of spectators gathered around the winner. So, pride of spectator is wrong. The correct one is a crowd of spectators gathered around the winner. The second one is my suitcase rolled down the sets of chair. The sets of chair is the correct answer. The answers I have also written down. You can just go through it. The third one, did you find a bunch of keys on this table? I am giving you the right answer. Okay, the students pay attention. I am just giving you the correct answer of this sentence. The fourth one, the ship had a choir of abroad. The ship had a choir of singers abroad. The fifth one, a submarine followed a gaggle of geese. The fifth one is a submarine followed a gaggle of geese. The sixth one is now the exercise F is a fill in the blanks using the correct collective noun. The first one is the clerk tripped and dropped the whole sheaf of papers. The second one is the little boy was frightened by the colony of ants. Colony of ants is a collective noun. The third one is a bunch of judges sat down to discuss the matter. The fourth one, during a scuba diving session, we saw a shoals of fish darting about. The fifth one, the colonel was very strict with his army of soldiers. The sixth one, the police was looking for the notorious gang of robbers. The seventh one, the deer hid behind a clump of trees. The eighth one, the teacher greeted the class of pupils. The ninth one is, the big building have several suites of offices. The tenth one is, after the program, the dancers bowed to the audience. The collective noun, also in this exercise, G, you have to fill in the blanks and you have, there is a blue box there, and you have to select the correct collective noun. The first one is, Mr. Bernie Wayne is a member of the board of director of the Ritu Textiles. Now, the second one is, Sudarshan can make a beautiful sculpture from the heap of sand. The heap of sand is a collective noun. The third one, the herd of cows came on the road and caused a traffic jam. The fourth one, the pack of wolves surrounded the rabbits. The fifth one is, a panel of experts was appointed to inquire about the accident. The panel of experts was appointed to inquire about the accident. The sixth one, a cloud of butterflies descended on the garden. The seventh one, the cast of actors reached the location in the early morning. The eighth one is, we have to remove the heaps of trash after the party. The heap of trash after the party. The fourth one is the abstract noun. Abstract noun is the name of ideas, qualities or feelings, we can say, such as friendship, honesty, kindness. There are various things of abstract down examples. The one such is we should be kind to animals. So here, kind. Kind is an abstract noun. So here in abstract noun, often some of the words are formed from adjectives. See, the brave army men fought in the battle. So your brave is an adjective. It can be also changed into abstract noun, such as brave can be changed into bravery in the form of abstract noun. The abstract noun, we can also change the verb into abstract noun. The example is like this. Ram knows German very well. So here, knows is the verb. When I have to change into abstract noun, the knows verb can be formed into the word knowledge. Now in exercise H, you have to circle the abstract noun. In this exercise, there are 15 words. In that, I have just written the correct answer of abstract. The first one is sorrow, happiness, anger, grief, despair, hope, tolerance. So all these words come under the abstract noun. As I told you before, that abstract noun is a quality, is a feeling. So all this comes in the example of abstract noun. Now in exercise I, you have to change the underlined words into abstract noun. The first one, soldiers moved ahead courageously. Everyone praised them. Everyone praised the soldiers for their courage. So here courageously has been formed into the word courage. The second one is, we should be kind to animals. The kind is the word that is underlined. The correct form will be like this. Let's show kindness to animals. The third one, the teacher was patient with the children. Patient is the word that is underlined there. And you have to change it to abstract noun. That is, the teacher showed a lot of patience with the children. The fourth one is, the lazy people often fail. The correct word is, some people often fail due to their laziness. The fifth one is, Mr. Menon is so gentle that all the people like him. Here the word gentle is a underlined one. Now you have to change it into abstract noun. So the correct answer will be like this. Mr. Menon's gentleness make him likable to all the people. In exercise J, you have to put a correct tick on the following sentences to find out what is the correct abstract noun. One is like this. My teacher gave me a good piece of. The two words are there in the bracket. You have to put a correct tick mark for the correct abstract noun. So my teacher gave me a good piece of advice. Patience. The correct answer is advice. The second one. The detective's intelligence, kindness helped him to solve the case. So I will be just reading the correct form of abstract noun. The detective's intelligence helped him to solve the case. The third one, pride always has a fall. The fourth sentence, the Birbal's wisdom made him famous in Akbar's court. I will repeat the fourth one, Birbal's wisdom made him famous in Akbar's court or Akbar's kingdom. The fifth one, Subhash Chandra Bose showed a great patriotism and fought for his country. The fifth one, honesty is the best policy. So hope you have understood all that six sentences. In that you have to put just a tick mark, a correct right mark to get the correct abstract noun. Now in exercise K, you have to find out filling the blanks with both the forms. It might be some word will be written in verb, you have to find out abstract noun and vice versa. Means some of the words you might be in abstract noun, you will be writing the verb form. The first one is arrive, the correct is abstract noun is arrival. Here choose is choice, abstract noun. The third one is invade. The abstract noun is invention. The fourth one is invade. The abstract noun is invention. The fifth one is defend. The abstract noun is defense. The sixth one is depart. The abstract noun is departure. The seventh one is discovery. The abstract noun is discovery. The eighth one is destroy. The abstract noun is destruction. The ninth one is prevent. The verb is prevent. The abstract noun is prevention. The tenth one is interfere. And the abstract noun will be interference. So again in exercise 11, fill in the blanks with abstract noun. The first one is like this. Ambika needed her teacher's dash to leave the class. The word is given here, permit. The abstract noun of permit will be permission. The second blank is, the doctors waited for the arrival of the child's mother. The third one, hatred leads to violence. The fourth one, India achieved its freedom after much struggle. The fifth one, the length of this room is exactly the same as its breadth. The sixth one, there are lots of excitement in the classroom when the teacher announced the picnic. So one more type of the noun is a possessive form of noun. In this, the possessive means the belongings or the ownership of someone's. In that, the second sub-point that you have to remember in the possessive noun is you have to always put an apostrophe. Apostrophe means a small sign on the up there, down, like a comma. And there are four different forms. Now, might be there for a lot of questions in your mind, where I should put a commas and all. I'll just give you the four main points. Now, in which word are singular or plural, where you have to put a apostrophe. The first one is, with the singular noun, you have to add apostrophe and s. The second one is, to the plural noun, you have with the end with s, you have to just add only apostrophe. And the third one, the plural noun that do not end with s, you have to add apostrophe and s. And the last one is, the belongings that is more than one person, you have to add apostrophe to the last of the noun. One such example is like this, Renu, Ruby and Raj, R-A-J apostrophe S, Raj's bags. In a possessive noun, I have told you also that in possessive noun you have to put an apostrophe here in sentences or the words. So here in this exercise N, you have to add apostrophe to the following sentences where it is required. The first one, the teacher's table was painted red, which annoyed her very much. Here, in this, I have put apostrophe, T-E-A-C-H-E-R, apostrophe, S, teachers. In this way, the second will be like this. My father's office is near to my mother's office. The third one, the women's dresses were very expensive, even after the discount. The fourth one, Anila is packing Anu, Rima and Sanjay's, apostrophe S, Sanjay's lunch. The fifth one, three boys, B-O-Y-S, apostrophe. Boys' bikes were parked in the driveway. I'm repeating the fifth one. The three boys' bikes were parked in the driveway. The sixth one, where is Harjinder's pencil box? The seventh one is, I put on Raja's, R-A-J-A apostrophe S, Raja's hat by mistake.